Let's talk about a zebra cake. It's a cake that's a zebra and a zebra that's a cake. And basically, it's a cake that's made love with a zebra and results in the most light and fluffy vanilla cocoa sponge that you will ever have seen in your life. So it's gonna be spectacular. So stick with me, my friends. This is gonna take a little bit of scooping, a little bit of mixing, but we are gonna end in the most beautiful marbled zebra cake you ever did see. Now, it starts off by sieving through some plain flour into our bowl to create a very light and airy zebra cake batter. Now, in making this zebra cake, I've actually adapted a recipe I already have for a naughty chocolate fudge cake, which is one I've been making for years and years and years. And then I saw this on Pinterest and thought, this is the perfect batter that can be adapted to make a zebra cake, and that's exactly where we're at. So, we've got flour sifted in, we've got sugar going in. I'm going to sift in about a teaspoon of baking powder in here as well, just to give us a nice little rise. And basically, once you have your dry ingredients in here, it's just a case of mixing these up just so that they're evenly combined. So for our wet ingredients, we have some milk. Some milk goes in. We have a little bit of sunflower oil. I say a little bit, it's quite a lot of sunflower oil, but this cake doesn't require any other fat bar the sunflower oil. There's no butter in here, so it's actually quite a good one if you have people who can't eat butter. We've also got 4 eggs going in here, so crack them straight in here. And I love recipes that are sort of all-in-one mixes. You have your dry ingredients, you have your wet ingredients, and then everything comes together in a truly beautiful little moment and creates the most spectacular cake batter you ever did see. As you can tell, I'm a little bit excited about this zebra cake. Right, 4 eggs going in here. Give them just a little mix up. Okay, this is nicely mixed up. A tiny touch of fragrance from some vanilla goes in here. Give that a last whisk up. And now it's just a case of pouring the wet into the dry and getting it all mixed up. So, straight into the center. I'm gonna get in there with a wooden spoon and just mix it on up. Slowly but surely, work those wet ingredients into the dry ingredients and you should be left with a nice, smooth batter. Okay, this is looking pretty good. You wanna stop stirring as soon as it's nicely incorporated, that flour and the wet and the dry and all is looking good. This is a fantastic batter to use for a whole host of different cakes. You can flavor it up with whatever you like. I am actually going to flavor it with a little bit of cocoa powder, and this is where our zebra moment comes in. So, we're gonna split half this mix into one bowl. Now this goes in there. So I've got about half the mix in here, I have about half the mix in here, and now it's just a case of grabbing up that sieve again and sifting in that cocoa powder into one of the bowls. So as soon as that is in there, just fold that through until you have a nice, thick and dark batter. Okay, this looks pretty good now. So essentially, I have a light batter, I have a dark batter, and now we are going to combine the two in a cake tin lined with some parchment paper on all sides. And now this is the exciting part. This is where it gets a little bit interesting. This is where you take a chocolate cake and a vanilla cake and you make a beautiful zebra baby. Okay, so we've got 2 ice cream scoops, one for the vanilla, one for the chocolate. And now I'm gonna take a scoop of that chocolate mixture, plop it straight in the center, and then slowly but surely just work my way through vanilla, chocolate, vanilla, chocolate, vanilla, chocolate, vanilla, chocolate, until I've used up the entire batter. Let's do this. Now, it does take a little bit of patience, but once you concentrate and you start to layer up those wonderful little stripes, you will see that it is so worth it. And it's really a cake that has a point of difference. It looks so fantastic, even at this stage before it's gone in the oven. Okay, it's done. It is ready for the oven, and just look at those perfect little stripes. This is now gonna bake in the oven for about 1 hour and 15 minutes. It's a long bake, but it's a big cake. And it's gonna cook off just until it's nicely risen. And when you insert a skewer, it comes out clean. That's what we're looking for. Right, it has had its time in the oven. It's cooled and you can see what a mammoth of a cake this is. It's huge. But now this is the moment of truth. This is where we see, do we have that beautiful marbled effect running all the way through? So I'm gonna just slice into it. You could finish this off with a glaze if you fancy, but actually, it's quite a moist cake and it's a lovely thing to have alongside a cup of tea. And who wouldn't love a cup of tea and a bit of cake? So just slice down. Okay, this is the moment of truth. That is what I'm talking about. Look how beautiful those fantastic zebra stripe layers are. Swirled cocoa and vanilla all in one go. It's like ebony and ivory. Ebony and ivory go together. Let's just eat the cake now. It's such a reliable recipe because I've made this a million times as a chocolate cake, but when you swirl it through like this, you actually get the contrast of the cocoa and the vanilla all in one bite. It makes a really moist and sort of light tea cake. I actually don't think it needs a glaze because it's wonderfully sweet. It's scented with vanilla. I know there's a lot of work in making those stripes, but it is worth it. It pays off. I mean, that is the wow moment once you take this out, slice it up, and it's ready to go. If you want the recipe for this beautiful zebra cake, I will leave it in the link in the box below, which will bring you to my website and you can get all the details there. Subscribe to this channel for lots more delicious baking recipes just like this one. Give us a like, leave us a comment, and I'll see you soon. Happy zebra cake making. Enjoy. Truth, the big reveal. Oh yes, that is what we're after. Beautiful. God damn it. The cake, it's an animal.